What's up, everybody? Welcome back to the Get A List Fit Show. I am Jaron Fran. I am your host. I'm your guide. I'm your radio announcer. I was about to reference Little Shop of Horrors, to be honest. I'm your loving queen. Take a chance. Just feed me it. You know I don't know the words, so that's why I didn't reference it. But then I ended up just referencing it without knowing the words. And here I am now wasting precious seconds on this podcast episode talking about a reference I don't know fully know the words to. But anyway, and I call myself a real musical theater lover. Come on. I did Little Shop of Horrors. Was I in high school? I think so, yeah. I was Seymour. And it was a great time, and I've just loved that show ever since. The movie, all the Broadway/off-Broadway versions right now, I keep up with it. Every single clip I can get my hands on, I love it. What do they call them? Like, slime tutorials is like the slang that we use on TikTok, apparently, to talk about a bootleg. You know, people illegally filming a production and then uploading it later. Anyway, look at this tangent that I've already on. Here we are, back for another episode. We're going to get into today's theme about fitness and how you just can't be all or nothing with your fitness. You got to be slow and steady. But before I get to that, I want to just kind of fill you in on a couple life updates, because part of this project of mine, sharing my life through podcast format, is, you know, sharing these lessons and just giving you a little sneak peek at behind the scenes of my life. One thing I have to come clean about, and this is really hard for me to do. Like, honestly, it's actually hard because I feel lame. I feel lame, guys. We're not perfect. I know we're not all perfect, but I told you on this podcast that I was going to run a 5K, and I had every single intention to. Paid the money, registered, got my little name tag, my little chest flag or whatever, and I even got a t-shirt. Now, the t-shirt was free. It was, I should have known right then and there that this was not meant to be, because I guess I ordered a women's large shirt, and it was, you know, slim cut in a weird way with a V-neck to show off my cleavage, and that I don't have. And I was like, man, I really wanted this damn t-shirt, but nope. I got a weird shirt. So anyway, my wife will wear it. But I did not end up running the race. I'm sorry. I have to apologize because I put it out there. I'm really mainly apologizing to myself. I set myself up for, you know, a high expectation that I didn't follow through with. And that sucks. That doesn't feel great, especially because I'm holding myself accountable and being honest about it. One of my core beliefs is radical responsibility. Take ownership of what went wrong and how you can correct it, right? Take ownership of where you're at in your life, because whether you realize it or not, like, you created this, you created your life. And I know we're all born through different circumstances and all that, and that's, we can get pretty deep into that. But if you're not happy with where you are in your life, you got to acknowledge that, like, the actions that you've taken, you and you alone, have led you to where you want to be, which is really kind of sounds heavy, but it's actually exciting, because if you don't like your life or your current circumstances, you can change them by taking those same actions or different actions, really. So that's encouraging. Anyway, my point with that is I didn't run this damn race because the night before my brother and his wife got here, we had a crazy, crazy weekend. Lots of family stuff, which is cool, friend stuff. We were just, you know, being a dad of a toddler is no excuse, but we were getting burnt out, and it was raining. It was not the best route for this race, really inconvenient. And we just decided, you know what, I think what would be actually more effective is if we just kind of spend more time together. We don't have to go to bed early. Like, let's hang out, let's spend the morning together, and quality time to me matters most. So that's what happened. Now, I have run a 5K. I ran on the treadmill. I prepped for it. You know, I've done it multiple times on the summer, and I will do it again. And I really got to hold myself to it, because I'm telling you guys. But, well, there's a lesson to be learned here, you know. I think maybe radical responsibility is the lesson. I'm being real and transparent about something that I set myself up to do and I didn't follow through, and it sucks. So how do I improve? Well, next time I make a better plan, or next time I, like, research it a little bit more besides just saying, like, sure, I'll do it. Like, if it wasn't going to work for us, I should have known that and picked a different race, for example. But anyway, I'm being real. I'm being real. Now, the other really cool thing that happened this week is three people have reached out to me about the podcast, and that is so freaking cool. Two people told me they have been using the 5-second rule. They really liked that. The 5-second rule by Mel Robbins is something I referenced in the very first episode. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, take action and go. And it really helps develop the habit of taking action. So please go listen to that and go read the book. It's so good. And now the other person told me that they listened to the podcast and they laughed out loud 5 or 6 times. Now, this person was not related to me, let me just tell you. It wasn't my mom. Like, somebody out there was listening, and that's so cool, and I appreciate it. So if you're out there and you're listening, send me a note so I can continue to brag about how amazing this podcast is. No, I'm just kidding. I'm not expecting to blow people out of the water here, but I want to deliver some value. I want to showcase, you know, how to live an A-list life and how I do it in my world so that you can be inspired and motivated and compelled to do it for you. Because again, that's the whole mission of getting A-list fit. You don't have to be a Hollywood A-lister to have a Hollywood A-list body. You don't have to have Hollywood A-list money to live an A-list life. You can live your life with confidence no matter where you are, no matter what you do, no matter what your body fat percentage is. You can have it all. It's possible. If I can do it, you can do it. So with that, I want to just take a quick second, a detour into something that really impacted me and I know impacted so many people in the theater community. And that was the sudden and really shocking passing of a Broadway icon, Gavin Creel. It was so shocking. He was diagnosed with sarcoma, a aggressive form of cancer, in July of this year and passed September 30th, or at least that's when it was announced, I believe. And man, I have so many friends and clients that actually knew him and were close to him and in his circle. And, you know, reading story after story, even though I didn't know him personally, I felt every one of those stories was so real, because the way I could best describe it was that he was truly a light. Obviously, his talent was incredible. He was a modern blueprint for like the male musical theater artist of how to have a successful career in the theater, but also he led his life, followed his passions, and stood up for what he believed in. And to me, that's a person of an integrity. That is someone truly to look up to. He was a leader. He was an incredible artist, but a leader, and he was a light. And I could feel that through his music on stage and the music he wrote. I could see that in the work he did, for activism around marriage equality and trans rights. And man, it really affected me, where I was going down rabbit holes of just watching clip after clip, people reading, you know, posting their stories and reading them all word for word. And it's just so cool to see how somebody could affect a community of people, even if you didn't really know him personally. So the lesson to be learned here is, like, let's honor him by living full out. I mean, that was clear. I mean, he was in Hair, the Broadway revival of Hair, where he played Claude, the lead, and sang I Got Life, and someone said that was truly him. Ben Pasek of Pasek and Paul shared a screenshot of one of their exchanges and texts saying, you know, what Gavin texted him saying, what this time has taught me is that there's no excuse not to live. If you are alive, you must live. And not living is no longer an option. So please, out there, you know, even if you didn't know him personally, or you don't even know who I'm talking about, just know that there was an incredible man, an incredible artist that affected so many people, and his time was cut short, and it hurts to even think about it. We got to honor him and his memory by living full out as if he did, you know, the way he lived his life. It's not an option to take your life or to take your health for granted. It could be snapped away from any one of us. We need to take care of ourselves. We need to use every single moment with purpose and intention, because not everybody is fortunate enough to have that. We got to use our lives. We got to use our time on this earth powerfully, as he did. And just wishing him and his family the best, and anybody that knew him or just was affected by him, you know, from afar, like I was, like, we gotta rally. We gotta live our lives as he would want. So may his memory be a blessing. And let's continue to honor the great artist that was. If you haven't ever listened to some of his music, just type his name in Spotify, like just his Broadway show tune catalog, but also his own music, like Quiet, his EP, literally was the soundtrack to my college years. That was my ringtone for my wife, Green to Gray. Let it be you. Oh, I'm waiting. Let it be you to come and rescue me. So good. Not me, Gavin Creel, and his writing was so good. Is that the first time I've sung on this podcast? Wow. Because if you guys don't realize it, I'm a pretty animated person. If you're watching on YouTube, hey, what's up? You can probably see all my hand motions and my facial expressions. And if you don't believe that I'm singing every other second that I'm not on this podcast, then you're crazy. Because I'm always singing. I'm always singing. My brother would always, when I was growing up, he'd be like, oh my God, stop. My wife definitely has gotten to that point. But, you know, she loves me for it. Now, my two-year-old daughter, if she ever says, I mean, she has, like, we're singing Wheels on the Bus. And she's like, no, Dada, no. Stop singing. Simi sings, right? If she, because she wants to sing it, I'm like, okay, this is a taste of my own medicine, I guess. God's way of, of, you know, just showing me exactly what I was when I was growing up. That will hurt if she continues that. But right now, she's two, so she just wants to sing herself that Wheels on the Bus song. She's obsessed. That song can really slap, you know, especially when you get creative with the verses. Anyway, moving on. Let's get into today's topic. This concept that fitness is all or nothing, because it ain't, guys. I've said it before, I'll say it again. If you think that getting results in your body takes a drastic overhaul of your life, you're wrong. Sit down, you're rocking the boat. And here's why you're wrong. You know, I think there's this false image, like the Biggest Loser. People come into your house and throw all the junk food away in your fridge and starts fresh, or, you know, they go through the closet and tear up all like the big clothes, and you're only gonna wear tennis shoes and work out athleisure from now on. That was just for TV, right? Like, no one's coming to do that. And in fact, going cold turkey like that is not the best method of getting results, because it's not the most sustainable method of getting results. And I know people that have worked on The Biggest Losers where they openly admit that because they were so crazy and extreme and restrictive with the workout and the diet, a lot of those participants unfortunately gained a lot of that weight back. We don't want that. We don't want that. So let me tell you right now, if you're out there trying to make a change in your health, in your body, lose some weight, build some muscle, stop thinking that you got to go all in, because that ain't it. Instead, we got to focus on slow and steady progress, little by little. Do what's manageable for you. Don't set yourself up to some unrealistic expectation that every single workout's gonna be 10 out of 10, 100%. Sometimes we got work to focus on. We're getting distracted and our workout's a little bit wishy-washy. Or sometimes your body's literally sore, and even though you wanna work out to your fullest extent, you just physically can't because you're just moving a little bit slower. So most people think that, like, if they're not spending hours in the gym or they're not following the perfect meal plan, that they're failing. They believe that if they really can't give it 100% of their effort all the time, they might as well not try. That's the danger of all or nothing. You're either all or you're nothing. You're either full into the workouts or you're just not working out at all. That's dangerous. If that's you, I get it. Like, because I used to think that too. Now, not only is the all or nothing mindset stopping you from making your progress, like it's holding you back, not just physically from the progress, but like mentally long term. It makes you feel like if you're not perfect, you know, it's impossible to get results. False. When you can't be perfect with your workout, then you end up giving up. And that's like a really sick cycle to be in. It just leaves you frustrated. It leaves you annoyed, feeling like you're not good enough. And that's not cool. So if I told you there was a different way, a way that doesn't require getting, you know, a gym membership, or doesn't require you being in the gym constantly for hours on end, or a different way that doesn't require like any extreme diets, would you be into that? If you're like, yeah, tell me more. Cool. I will tell you more. There's a way to make fitness and working out fit into your life so you can really still enjoy your favorite foods, that you can have time for your family and your other passions. You can make progress without sacrificing your mental health. Fitness does not have to be all or nothing. It's got to be about consistency, not perfection. So I want to share with you a little bit of my process, the Get A List Fit method. Because that's what my program is built on. I like to say I'm tricking my clients into adopting a healthier lifestyle by adding healthier habits little by little. And it starts with training for life and understanding that we're not training for a specific result. Yes, a lot of people come to me because they want to lose weight, but it's not as if we're training for a bodybuilding show. Yes, I've helped clients prepare for a marathon, but it's not like there's a big finish line at the end where you're just done. Okay, I achieved my results. I'm done working out forever. No, we know that. As long as you're focused and you have effective workouts, that can really fit into a short time frame. So the first thing I just want to remind you of is like if you have a busy schedule and you've felt before like, man, this thing is just impossible. I just don't have time to work out. Like, how could I keep up with this? Good news, you don't have to. You don't have to. I have one client, for example, that, you know, he works in theater. So like his schedule while he's rehearsing for a show is totally different when he's performing for a show. And then of course there's that dreaded tech week where everything goes to hell because you're literally, you know, hours on end in the theater teching a tedious process to prep for the actual opening. I said, hey, wait a minute. What if we just like pull back here for a second? It looks as if like you need to front load your week. Mondays are usually dark days in the theater, so there's no, you know, rehearsal or show. So why don't we definitely put a workout there? Tuesdays, you can work out. Wednesdays, you got a matinee and an evening show, a two-show day. Let's maybe not work out on that day. Thursday, go for it. Friday, if you're feeling it. Saturday, no. Sunday, take off, right? Like, let's adjust this in, you know, workout schedule to be a little bit more manageable for you and front load the week with workouts. Take off during matinees, right? These are like the nuances that we all need to consider for our lives. Like what just works best for me? Some people like to work out on the weekends, other people not at all. Cool. Do what works for you or else it's not going to work for you, you know? One of my clients, another one, came to me frustrated because she felt like she really had to change her ways to see any results in her body. And she didn't like that. She was resisting that. And the more you resist that, the worse it's going to be for you. You're making it harder on yourself. So within just a few simple weeks of just shifting her mindset, we didn't do anything crazy with workouts. We just got her moving a little bit more. She started to see results because she was less stressed about the outcome. She was more at peace. She was becoming more at peace with going slow and steady. And it's working for her. So you need a plan that works for your life. You know, you can't fit, what did I used to say? Like fitness should fit into your life, not the other way around. Like your life doesn't have to fit around your workout plan because that's no fun. So you don't need to turn your life upside down for results. My methodology works because it's built on real life and not some unrealistic expectation where you need to be at the gym 7 days a week for 2 hours on end. Nobody's got time for that. Same thing with the diet too. Like you should be able to eat the food you love, have some balance with it, and make good choices, of course. But also, like, I don't want you to feel like you're stuffing yourself just to bulk up, or I don't want you to feel like you're ever starving yourself just to, like, lose weight. Like, that's technically science of it, calories in versus calories out. You've probably heard that before. It's actually a lot more nuanced than that because you've got to take into account your lifestyle, your activity level, your metabolism. Ooh, your metabolism, that's a huge thing to talk about. I just want to zoom out here and before I get into the metabolism part, just tell you, focus on consistency, focus on regular movement, focus on a plan or a schedule that works well for you. If you have 20 minutes for a workout, great. That's enough. That's enough for right now. Prioritize strength training always, always efficient workouts. The most efficient way to work out, I'll tell you right now, is strength training. Building muscle helps you become more metabolically active. When you're more metabolically active, you have less You burn through calories more effectively. Simple as that. And again, with your nutrition, allow some flexibility in there. I remind my clients, don't make judgments about your food. Just make observation. When do you feel the best and what did you eat that day? When do you feel the worst and what did you eat that day? Just like make observations. And then naturally, instinctively, you're going to want to make better choices because now you understand what feels good for you and what doesn't, right? So little by little, progress is progress, even if it's not perfect, small, consistent effort. I think I'll probably say that every single episode of this podcast because it's that important. Now, let me go back to that metabolism thing here because a lot of people start dieting before they're even ready to diet. A lot of people think, oh, I can just cut calories. Like I said, calories in versus calories out. It's that simple, right? Eat less, move a little bit more. Got it. Wrong. That is a part of it. Totally. But that's not where everybody should start. I think I said it last week. If you followed the perfect diet and you weren't seeing results, wouldn't you be like, what the heck's going on? I'm doing all this work for nothing? That's because you don't know if your body is ready for fat loss. You don't know if your body is ready for a diet. You don't know if your body is ready for bulking up or getting shredded, right? So you need to have some clarity on where your body is sitting at. The first stage of Get A-List Fit is A-List priming, priming your body for what you want. You got to train your body to work for you rather than against you. But if you don't know what your starting point is, if you don't know your score, then you're just shooting blind, you know? So that's why I created the Get A-List Fit assessment, to help you understand in the three categories of, you know, fitness, diet, and mindset, where you're sitting at, what your metabolic score, what your Get A-List Fit score is, so that then we can build a plan to actually, you know, fit with where you're at, you know? So I think I put it in the chat last time, but I'll say it again. The quiz down below is linked right there. And, you know, I unlock a few spots every week. If you want to take it, go for it. But it might not be active when, if you're listening to this 3 months from now, just reach out to me. But check out that link and take that quiz. And there we can at least give you some starting steps. And there's no strings attached. I'm just truly going to give you your score and tell you what's going to be best for you in terms of next steps, so you can optimize your result. Because I think it's important to bring this all back into full circle. Like, the reason I'm so inspired to help people with their bodies and their health is because, number one, to make it really relevant, we don't have that much time in this world. And we all deserve to live a life that we feel good about. I realized when I got to New York that I was tired of not living up to my potential. I remember hearing that, and like someone said, wow, you have a lot of potential. And to me, it almost feels like a dirty word. It's like, you've got potential, but like you're not there yet. And I teased a little bit about how I missed my big break. I missed a huge opportunity because I wasn't living up to my potential. And that hurts. It still hurts. I'll share that story someday, I promise. And I just was sick and tired of not being the best version I could be. I realized that my health and my wellness was not a reflection of not only the roles that I wanted to play as like a young leading man, but I also, my body and my health and my wellness was not a reflection of the person that I knew I was inside. I was living half of a life. And I decided to take charge. Like I started this episode by talking about radical responsibility. Take charge of your life. Like, stop stalling, stop waiting. And if you're tired of trying to figure it out on your own, then reach out. This is what I do, you know? And by the way, it's not a matter of if you can figure it out, or it's really a matter of when you're going to figure it out. It's like, how long do you want to wait to figure it out? We don't have that much time. So take serious action for yourself. You owe it to your future. You owe it to your future self to get serious right now to make some changes. So I'm here for you. And that's like my mission. That's why I'm so passionate about this, because I don't want to see people stuck. I don't want to see people suffer one more day than they have to. We all deserve to live up to our fullest potential, so that word's not even an option anymore. No more potential. We are just living our best lives. Period. The end. We're thriving. We have it all. We got the family. We got the body. We got the financial health. We got the purpose and the intention and the fulfillment in what we do in this world. Like, it's possible, guys. It's so possible. And everything you do is connected to your health. So why not get started there? Right? So I hope you learned a little bit of something here. I hope you learned a little bit about me and my process, and most importantly, understanding that you got to get out of your head about this. It's not all or nothing. It's little by little. You can make changes. It's totally possible for you. Because if it was possible for me, it's absolutely possible for you. I'm coming from, you know, I wasn't going to call myself lazy, but like, yeah, I was a little lazy. And I didn't put my best effort into it. I didn't put all my 100% energy into it, bro. That's not what I mean. I didn't put like my energy behind it, even a little bit. And then I ended up struggling so much when I got to New York, and I just wasn't happy with who I was. But then I did. Then I did. And again, it wasn't like I was spending hours in the gym. It was like 40 minutes to 60 minutes in the gym. And then guess what? I don't always go to the gym to work out. Sometimes I do some stuff at home because I just, you know, that's what feels good to me that day. You just got to have the right strategy, the right support system, and the right intention if you want results. I can't help you with the intention, but I can help you with the strategy and the support. Hopefully this podcast lights a fire under your butt to get in the right mindset. All right, guys. If you listen this long, shout out to you. I hope you're enjoying the show. Leave a review. Leave a star. 5 stars, actually. Not just one. That wouldn't be good. Give me 5 stars. Come on. And reach out. If you need anything, I'm just a message away. Love you so much. Thanks for listening. See you in the next episode of the Get A List Fit Show. Talk to you later. Bye.